Welcome back to my channel, and today I want to share with you the shedding process of my Rhino Red Snake Reggie. I'll take you through all the stages of what a shedding process entails. So it's from noticing when it's gonna happen, what are the signs, and I filmed as much as I can of what happens in that process. And in the end of the video, I'll get Reggie out of his enclosure and then I'll show you his new fresh skin. So if you're into that, please keep watching. The first stage, when your snake is gonna go in the shed, what happens to my Reggie, he spends a lot of time in the water. It's more than usual. He'll change his usual behavior to something else, and mine just stays in his water bowl for maybe a week, and he refuses to eat. So maybe if he refuses to eat for the second time that you offer the food, there's something up. And I've noticed that when my snake does that and then spends a lot of time in the water, then I'll know he's going into shed. Sometimes it happens that he'll stay for a whole week in the same water, and I'll have to like physically push him out of the bowl so I can change his water, because I don't have a bubbler in his water bowl. I do have two separate bowls, so he can pick and choose where he wants to lay, but sometimes he just picks one and stays there for the whole week, and it's not that fresh if you don't change the water. So I'll try to change it as much as I can without disturbing him too much. After you've noticed that he's in the water for quite some time, he'll notice that he'll become a different color, more gray, bluish color, and that's called being in the blue. And for snakes, that means that they're going into shed. So what happens is that the skin, the new skin, is underneath the old skin. And there's this, I don't know how to say it in English, but I'm guessing it's lactic acid. It's like a milk acid that's in between the new and the old skin. And they're trying to make room in between that. What you'll notice is that the eyes will have like a blue grayish color, and it will like be totally gray at some point, or white. I think I have a photo of that, but I will call him Ghost Reggie. That's stage number three. This is when he's in the blue, in the water, he doesn't do anything, he doesn't eat, you don't try to give him food, he's not gonna take it, it's only a waste of the mice. And he'll stay in the water as long as he wants to. I've moved him once because he was staying there for a little bit too long, maybe 2 to 3 days, and I needed to change the water. If I'm careful, I'll just pour some water like over it so that the old water can go out. I don't know if that's the correct way, but I don't know what else to do. Because, yeah, I don't want to push him out of the bowl. I kind of did that at some point with my new snake hook. But I'd rather not, because he looks fragile and I don't recommend it. So if you have a bubbler, that's probably the best thing to have. But if you don't, you gotta change the water at some point. So I think you can estimate whether you can or cannot do that. So for me, this time, in this shedding process, it was not a big deal. He shed perfectly, so that's what happened. So after 2 or 3 days of being Ghost Reggie, he will return back to normal. And he'll go out of the water and will spend just normally. He will spend his time normally on wherever he wants to be. The only thing is that he looks a little grayish. He looks more like he needs some body lotion. He needs to moisturize a little bit. So what happens is, after he soaked in the water for all that time, the skin got loose, and it created, and it became easier to separate the old skin from the new skin. And now that he's out of the water, he's drying up, and it just looks like dry skin on top of his normal skin, but it's super thin, so you won't see it that much. But you'll know that it's not the same bright color your snake has when before all this happened. This will take probably 2 to 3 days, not that long, and the shedding process will definitely start after the being in the blue stage. That's when it's gonna happen. After this gray, dry skin stage, this is when a shedding is going to happen. So I was fortunate enough to be at home when this happened. It's the second time I was home because of quarantine. I'm working from home, so I could set up a tripod and try to film as much as I can. And I'll show you some clips on the screen while I just talk through it. So at first they'll try to break free from the mouth. So when you notice that your snake opens their mouth really widely, like he's yawning, he's actually stretching his skin out. I got this on camera and it looks really cool. And it will just flick over his nose and he'll rub his head on the branches he has in his enclosure and it will just peel off. And the first time he was with me, the first time only the head piece came off and then it ripped from the body piece, but this time it just stayed on in a total piece. So it's like peeling a banana or something. It just came off like smoothly. And I'll go get that skin. 2 seconds. I'm back with some skin. So when I pulled out the skin out of his terrarium, out of his enclosure, I used a tweezer and it ripped apart a bit. I have older skin that stayed all in one piece, but I'll just show you this one. It just looks like this. So this is his head. You can see that. This is where the eyes are. Sorry for my bad nails. Anyway, this is where his eyes are. You can see it on my brown skin a little bit better. And as you can see, it just ripped open like that. And then it peeled the other way. If you're wondering how it feels like the plastic balls that you can pinch. Like, I don't know how to say it in English, but in Dutch it's poppetjes plastic. And it's just directly translated into bubble plastic. Just does it like burp, 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 burp. I think we're at the point of the video that I get Reggie out of his enclosure and we'll just check him out, right? We're back. Hey. So as you can see, he's very nice bright green now. He just feels like he always feels. I didn't hold him when he was around shedding time, so I don't know the difference in when you hold him. Let's see if we can zoom in a little bit so I can stand a little further away. He had a little scab on his nose and it went away, like in one shed, and I'm very proud of that. Well, proud of him. I didn't really do much, but I don't think you can see it because I'm so fast. But I have a photo if I don't get it on camera. I know I don't have many views yet, but I just keep continue making videos and let me know in the comments what you like to see. Someone said a room tour with Reggie. But I was thinking, like, if I make videos with Reggie, just like normal videos, and just add Reggie to it, I don't know if that would be a nice thing to watch, honestly. So, yeah, I don't know. If you have particular videos that you like to see about rhino wrecked snakes, or just snakes, or fashion with snakes, live snakes, not dead snakes and designer handbags, then yeah, let me know. Thanks for watching. I hope you've learned something. I thought he was gonna go into my jumpsuit. He didn't. I hope you learned something. I didn't really teach you anything, but maybe you've now understood how the shedding process works, as in how you can notice it when it happens. But I imagine it's not gonna be very different from mine. Yeah, so thanks for the views. Which on my first video was only like 50, but I mean, that's a lot for me because it's my first video. And this is my second video, so I'm already thankful for that. Yeah, so let me know what you like to see. And if you have any questions that I can answer. And I'll see you next time, whenever I have something else cool to show. Okay, thank you for watching. Bye! Bye! Say bye, Reggie! Ooh!